to the 29th annual fall concert of your Oshkosh Area Community Band. This is our Halloween special this year. We've never had the opportunity to do this right on Halloween day, so that's going to bring you an extra exciting concert for this evening. We would like to move right along because we have lots of music and lots of fun for you this evening. Would you please extend a welcome along with our band of our musical director, Mr. Terry Hathaway. This evening with a couple of Dixieland pieces, and we'd like to call this group our Ha Ha Clinton Dixieland Band. Oh, you caught on. Very good. We start out with the clarinet marmalade, and later called the clarinet marmalade blues. It's a 1918 Dixieland jazz standard composed by Larry Shields and Henry Riggins of the original Dixieland Jazz Band. In 1926, it was recorded by Fletcher Anderson, the American pianist, band leader, arranger, and composer, who is ranked along with Duke Ellington as one of the most influential arrangers and band leaders in jazz history. We hope you enjoy this 1950 arrangement by Leroy Holmes, clarinet, marmalade, blues. Something really hot leg so that, you know, say, I told you it was going to be fun. Okay, so that's the clarinet marmalade blues, and now we're going to go to the Tiger Rag. It's a jazz standard originally recorded and incorporated by the original Dixieland Jazz Band in 1917. It's one of the most recorded jazz compositions of all time. In 2003, the 1918 ODJB recording of Tiger Rag was placed on the U.S. Library of Congress National Recording Registry. Henry Levine was expertly transcribing this composition for your enjoyment. Enjoy now Tiger Ray. I'd like to tell you about the next number. This is very special. We wanted to program this piece because this year is 150th anniversary of the end of the Civil War. This piece, written by Wisconsin composer Michael Sweeney, depicts some of the main events that occurred on July 3rd, the final day of a three-day epic battle of Gettysburg. Musical references include, first of all, early morning. Union officers reported hearing church bells from downtown Gettysburg as the 3 o'clock hour tolled in the darkness. The second section is drums and trumpets representing the opposite armies waking for the day's battle. Then the third phase is early in the afternoon. Two cannon blasts signaled Confederate gunners to begin firing on the Union positions on Cemetery Ridge. There is, in the next phase, a brief calm before the Confederates launch their infantry attack. The Union soldiers watch the parade-like advance in awe and amazement. In the next phase, the ill-fated Pickett's charge reaches the Union lines and fierce hand-to-hand fighting ensues. A brief quote from the song Kathleen Wolverine is heard lastly, and the opening theme returns, but in a more optimistic setting. The term high watermark refers to the fact that the Confederacy was never again a serious threat upon the northern soil. More than 170,000 soldiers were involved in the three-day battle, and more than 50,000 were killed or wounded. Ladies and gentlemen, here now, high watermark, the third day.
Thank you.
third day. Michael Sweeney. Glenn Osser was and is a well-known composer to band directors the world over. His Beguines are some of his best compositions, and this 1967 composition is one of his nicest. It is simply entitled Beguine Again. Also the 115th anniversary of the book, The Wizard of Oz. The story of The Wizard of Oz was written in 1900, and the movie we all know in 1938. What a classic story, what a classic movie, and what a classic piece of music Harold Arlen and E.Y. Harburg wrote for The Wizard of Oz. This 1995 arrangement by James Barnes is an overture on the themes from this MGM classic motion picture. This medley included in the overture will have In It, Over the Rainbow, Ding Dong, The Witch is Dead, We're Off to See the Wizard, The Merry Old Land of Oz, and If I Only Had a Brain. I'm sure it will be impossible for you to listen to these melodies without seeing in your mind's eye this wonderful movie. Here are selections from The Wizard of Oz.
Thank you.
witch is dead, we're off to see the wizard, the merry old land of Oz, and if only had a brain, a medley of music from the Wizard of Oz. At this point, we're going to make a switch now to stage band. We'll probably be bringing the elevator up in the front, and the stage band members will be moving out front, and while they do that, I'll read our director's notes on the next piece. Entitled, If It Don't Mean a Thing, It Ain't Got That Swing. This is a stage band piece. If you want to get up and dance in the aisles, you can do that. It's a 1931 composition by Duke Ellington, with lyrics by Irving Miles. Now accepted as a jazz standard, it was characterized by jazz historian Gunther Schuller as a prophetic piece and a prophetic title. The music was written and arranged by Ellington in August of 1931 during intermissions at Chicago's Lincoln Tavern, and was first recorded by Ellington and his orchestra on February 2nd of 1932. This recording of the song was inducted into the Grammy Hall of Fame in 2008. Tonight's 1994 arrangement is by Mark Taylor. Solos are by Dick Winters, alto sax, Ken Walker on the trumpet, Marshall Potter on the piano, and so, what I mean if I say I don't mean a thing, if it ain't got that swing. Enjoy our Oshkosh Area Community Band stage band, and it's okay if you get up and dance in the aisles if you like. By the way, all three of these bands, the Oshkosh Area Community Band, the Stage Band, and the Dixieland Group, all are performing during this next year out at the Wisconsin Veterans Home in King. Those concerts are held as concerts in the park and also inside the Martin Memorial Center. If you'd like to come out and join us for those concerts, we'll keep you alerted as to when they are. Thank you. This next one is a great old tune, except there's nothing old sounding about this 1998 arrangement by Peter Blair. It's a medium swing version of a marvelous, often played standard that was originally a 1945 French song. The French title actually meant Dead Leaves. The Hungarian translation is Falling Leaves, and Johnny Mercer changed it to Autumn Leaves, an appropriate song for this time of the year. A lot nicer, don't you think? Covering the vibraphone will be Mary Rank, and appropriate for tonight's concert, Autumn Leaves. Said that one of the nice things about watching a live band produce this music is that you've known this music for years, you have it in your head, but you may have never seen it performed live, and to see musicians recreate this music, much of it from a long time ago, the great tunes by live musicians is a special experience. You'll take it home and it'll ring in your head for hours. Our next one, I like the title of Chili Today and Hot Tamale. It's a tightly constructed work that borrows liberally from the Latin jazz. It imitates the great traditions of this musical style and is reminiscent of those heard in Tito Puente's music. If you listen to Henry Mancini's It Had Better Be Tonight from the Pink Panther soundtrack, we've been told that it bears some rhythmic resemblance to that piece. From 2014, here is Rick Hirsch's Chili Today and Hot Tamale, featuring John McNeil on the trombone and Roger Becker on the tenor sax. It's going to be exactly 12 and a half minutes. Check your clock, it'll be 20 hours, 8 bells, hand straight up, big hand for those of you that can't tell time, big hand straight up, other hand down there on the 8, no, whatever. We'll see you back at 8 o'clock. Be sure you're in your seat on time because we have some really exciting music for you in part 2 that you may have never heard this band do. Now we come to the scarier part of the concert. We We hope that you enjoy this trek down a spooky lane, because I think we just took the wrong fork in the musical road. At this point, let's welcome our director back to the stage, Mr. Terry Hathaway. Just in case you don't notice, he's the boss. He's directing the band with a hammer. That's different. Composer Brian Bulmacher states, "Those familiar with my music know that I often like to take traditional styles of music and rework them in a completely new way, such as the case with the March Diabolique, or if you wish, you can call it Diabolic. If you're a Frenchman, you call it Diabolique. The work makes extensive use of the tritone surrounded by an expansive, dark, harmonic language. Marked for band as menacing and deliberate, the music should come across as direct and somewhat invasive. Here from 2014 is March Diabolique." Thank you. We'd like to remind you that following this evening's concert, there'll be a reception out in the corner where the two halls meet. Refreshment and meet band members. Please meet us out there in the corner for a free reception. We'd like to thank Karen Martin for setting that up. The fact that this fall's concert fell on Halloween reminded band member Dave Burt of a song that he had sung many times with his granddaughter Jamie. It's called Goose Town Halloween and was written by John Forster. Every Halloween where John lives, the volunteer firefighters decorate the firehouse and invite all the neighborhood kids. Dave arranged the song for concert band, and we will share in the arrangement with you tonight. The song tells the story of what happened one Halloween night at the firehouse. Be ready to help with your part of the story. Please welcome Dave Burt, along with our director, Terry Hathaway.
Hi, neighbors. I'm glad we're together again. Tonight we are going to tell a story. It is about an incident that took place on one Halloween night not so long ago. Mr. Terry and the members of the band are going to help me tell it, but we need your help too. Somewhere in the middle of the story, you'll hear me sing, with the clanging and the honking and the screaming high siren. That is your cue to get ready. We have the clanging and the honking covered by the instruments in the band, but we need the screaming high sirens of the fire trucks. So that's you. So let's practice. Can we hear that now? Ready, go. Okay. Now, remember, when I say that it's your cue to get ready, don't start the sirens until I give you the high sign. Okay, and then if you're still going, I'll stop. I'll stop you. But then a short time further in the story, you'll hear me sing, and gathered all the chickens who'd escaped. And at that point, immediately, we need to hear some sounds of chickens escaping. So, ba-ba, ba-ba, ba-ba. Okay. Yeah, so chickens escaping, okay. Not ducks. And then finally, we'll need some corn popping sounds. All right, Mr. Terry, is the band ready? I think we're all set to start. So join us as we tell the story of that killer dilly thriller of a Goose Town Halloween. Every year when we're done trick-or-treating and we're all sick of eating Tootsie Rolls by the pound, off we go to a strange kind of meeting that's for every kid for miles around, down at the firehouse, where all the firefighters are putting on their yearly trick-or-treat. They drape the firehouse, they decorate the bumper, and I'll put on a costume or a sheet. As the witches and the zombies and the goblins all convene for a killer diller thriller of a Goose Town Halloween. But new this year in the rear of the station should a weird kind of station that gave all of us chills. Clanking chains and a nightmare vibration, well, it made you want to run for the hills. They built a spook house, those wacky firefighters, with sound effects and lightning they prepared. They made that firehouse a very scary area, and frankly, even I was kind of scared. As the witches and the zombies turned a lovely shade of green. On a killer diller thriller of a Goose Town Halloween. Little vampires started wailing. Little mummies were coming unwound. All at once, though, something happened that turned the whole evening around.
It's a fire! 2-alarm fire! Sorry, kids, the party's over.
It was a madhouse, with everybody running from the spook house to find their boots and helmets in the firehouse. A gremlin came a-sliding down the pole. A cobweb bumper and a skeleton crew. Frankenstein was driving and away they flew, with the clanging and the honking and the screaming high sirens. What a killer diller thriller of a Goose Town Halloween. Was turning, you could smell something burning, something very nearby. Where they stopped was extremely concerning. Well, the truth is that I wanted to cry. They stopped at my house, well, actually behind it at the hen house. The flames were leaping out, it was a madhouse. As everyone came running from the spook house to watch the ghouls and zombies from the firehouse spray water on the fire and gather the chickens who escaped. Took them a long time to escape. They were all safe. As the witches and the zombies on the big red fire machine had a killer diller thriller of a Goose Town Halloween. Now the flames, they were spreading to the chicken feed drop. All that corn that we stored in the shedding, you could hear it, it was starting to pop. Cross, Orville, Red and Backer, with a firecracker, I'm pretty sure that this would be the sound. Oh, everyone in town is gonna long recall the scene.
Had you been at the rehearsals, I think you would have thought the rehearsal was as much fun as the performance. Everybody was giggling and laughing and having a good time. The chickens were really golden. You did very well. Give yourselves a hand. And thank you to David Byrd. Good job, David. Okay, the next one is entitled The Witching Hour. Wait.
The percussion needs a lot of time to set up for this number, so this is my stall tactic. I need to tell you a very quick story about we had invited the band members to dress for the second half of the concert if they wished. They didn't have to, but we invited them to do that. And I made mention that I had figured out what I was probably going to wear, and somebody said, well, what are you going to wear? And of course, with my sense of humor, I told the band, I tried to come up with the scariest thing I could think of. Just absolutely frighten everybody. And I said, I can sum it up in one word. Speedo. And the band went all, ooh, and I said, see, it works.
Rehearsals with this band are fun. Okay, this next piece is entitled The Witching Hour. Musically illustrates the time of night when dark forces gather to celebrate and do their mischief. Midnight chimes signal the beginning of the terror-filled night. Once the hours have chimed, the gathering begins as the witches fly together in the hollows of the darkened wood. The second hour chimes, and the witches invoke their powers with spells and incantations. During the third hour, the witches begin to celebrate with a witch's dance that spirals out of control. Interrupted by the final chiming, they rush back to their lairs during the witch's flight. Enjoy this dark and exciting musical journey through tonight's witching hour. Is somebody supposed to do something out there? Oh, do that. There was a witch doing a thing out there. Come on, witch. Do it again. Beautiful. Beautiful. Well done.
Thank you.
1992 piece is a medley of familiar yet spooky themes, so good it's almost scary. Each of the classical themes is fully and powerfully scored by Tom Wallace and features Bach's Toccata and Fugue in D minor, Mussorgsky's Night on Bald Mountain, Chopin's Funeral March, and Gounod's Funeral March of the Marinette. The way these monumental themes are treated and interspersed with ghoulish touches is fun for us to play and hopefully fun for you to hear as well. Please enjoy the House of Horrors. The music boss has to clean his glasses. Is that blood? Water? Sweat? Musical perspiration.
Thank you.
for a little fun. Composer James Seiler has created a delightful lyrical waltz. Combine the medley with a tarantella and a march in a minor key to evoke autumn mischief and fun. This 2013 piece is a wonderful mix of pure melody with sinister twist. Here is Hocus Pocus.
Thank you.
point, we'd like to extend a thank you to a number of people. First of all, to Tom Hansen, our house master. He helps us with lighting, sound, and everything. And thank you, Tom. We appreciate everything that you do for us. We thank the Recreation Department and the Department of Education for the use of the facility. We're all happy to have you tonight using this facility to compliments of the Recreation Department, which is part of the Oshkosh Area School System. We want to thank David Burt for his special number tonight. Thank you, David. Good job. That was fun. The band had a good time producing that as well. We want to thank Karen Martin for preparing our reception out in the concert area in the convergence of the two halls after the concert. Please come and join us. We want to thank Kenny Walker for our imagery on the wall for the Civil War piece. And we want to thank our videographer, Quinn, who is videotaping tonight's performance for availability on WOCT Channel 2, Community Access TV, and Charter Cable 984. You'll be able to see this entire program again. Oh yes, and Dan Singer and Brian Wilson and the West High Band Room, we thank you for the use of that facility and a lot of that equipment. I'm being coached here, right? The band owns this center section of risers thanks to your generosity. We had to add ends to this for tonight's performance, and we want to thank North High School for lending us additional ends for the bleachers, the risers.
And the only thing I wanted to mention was, first of all, I personally appreciate everybody showing up to make the concert. I'm not talking about these people, I'm talking about you. Because I know that there were so many things going on this evening that were pulling you away from tonight's concert. So we really appreciate, personally, I appreciate, and I'm sure the band does, that you were here. And then also, just to get myself in a little bit of trouble, on your way out, if you happen to see the Bride of Frankenstein out there, that's my wife, which of course makes me. On your way out, if you see her, wish her a happy birthday.
I think she's in the corner up there. Let's sing the last line of it. This is to Amy. Happy birthday to you. Amy, stand up and wave. We want to extend an extra thank you to Amy. She is the band treasurer. She works hard for the band, and she does lots for us. And we really thank you, Amy. We appreciate everything that you do for us. Thank you. At this point in the concert, Mr. Hathaway felt that you might have heard enough spooky and dark and dreary and scary and sinister and menacing Halloween music. So he wanted to end the concert with a bright, upbeat concert march. So he chose one that he played in high school under Jim Croft's baton. Bandology, with its rich, full harmonies, simple melodies, and interesting counter melodies, we hope you will leave you with nice performance, feeling great. This is a really upbeat band. This is from 1963, when Terry was just a sophomore in high school. Please, just a year or two ago, please enjoy Bandology. otherwise you're going to be late for church. Clock changing time, yeah, early, that's right. Clock changing time was 2 o'clock in the morning, so make sure.